Gotta ask, were there nerves that when it happened, when you know, when you're watching your guy go against the other guy, is there a special feeling of concern or nerves?
まあ、ファンもそうだと思うんですね。ファンも多分その団体を背負ったり、あとはナショナリズムで国を背負ったりということもそうだと思うし、プロモーター同士もワクワクもするけど、やっぱり勝てば嬉しいし、負ければやっぱり悔しいと思うし、まあ、でもそれがこのスポーツにとってとっても大事なエッセンス、成功するためのエッセンスだと思うんで、ファンがワクワクしてもらう、それと同時にプロモーターもワクワク、ドキドキハラハラします。それがキーだと思います。
I think we have the same nerves as the fans. A lot of fans would definitely pick a side and obviously cheer for their nation, for their country, fighters for their country. But as a promoter, there's definitely a lot of things that go through your mind when you're fighting, when the fighters are fighting. So I think whatever the fans want is what the promoters should deliver.
Do you think cross promoting is healthy for the MMA industry? And if so, would you like to see more, not only with Bellator but with other promotions as well?
お互いにとってそれぞれの、僕らはまあ日本がメインの国でね。だから今回でも多分ベラトールをこれまで見てなかった日本の多くの人ファンが。総合格闘技のファン、スポーツのファンがベラトールのこの大会を見ることになると思います。それはダゾーンを通して見ることになると思いますし、逆にベラトール、ね、今回僕ら、ね、ライジンのファイターでトップのレナとか堀口が出ることでライジンってことを知ってもらうことになる。これはお互いにとってとってもいいクロスプロモーションになると思います。
Yeah, I do believe that cross promoting is a fantastic thing for the sport. And for both sides. Obviously, a lot of Japanese people will be introduced to Bellator through DAZN because of this fight. And we do believe that a lot of Americans or people watching DAZN will be introduced to Ryzen and Ryzen fighters because of this crossover. So overall, yes, it's definitely beneficial for both parties, and it's definitely a healthy thing for this industry.
Have you and Scott spoken about the potential for a Ryzen versus Bellator tournament?
もちろんこれ別に堀口とかレナに限ったことじゃないんでね、団体対団体でどんどん選手を積極的にチャンピオン同士がクロスしていく、お互いトレードしてっていうか交換していきますから、最終的には本当にベラトール対ライジンの団体の威信というかね、それぞれのプロモーションというかチームの威信をかけたそういう全面対抗戦っていうのができたらいい。
Yeah, the idea is, the idea is not to stop here with Reyna and Horiguchi. The idea is to continue to interact and send fighters with one another. So eventually, if we continue that, it would probably lead to something more like a fighters representing their organization on one side, and the other side will be representing the other. So eventually, it would probably lead there. But right now, it's just the beginning. But eventually, there's something to be looked at.
If Horiguchi wins, he has both belts. Is the plan for him to defend both belts in both organizations?
そうです。だから堀口は忙しくなると思います。
Yes.
この場で言っておきますけど、堀口が勝ちます。
I believe that Horiguchi is going to get busy. He's going to become busy because he's going to win.
Which one would
he have to keep first? Two belts day after tomorrow.Because I guarantee Horiguchi will win. Guaranteed. Yeah.
Okay, hypothetically, say Darien wins. Now they're 1-1. Fans going to want a trilogy fight. Which organization is going to host a trilogy fight?
Darien won the third or the fourth match. Third match. Which one?
Yeah. Maybe we can take the middle and then do something in Hawaii.
で1ラウンド目ドローして、1ラウンド目ケージとリング組んどいて、どっちかで1ラウンド目2ラウンド目で交代して
、 Maybe we can have both cage and rings set up and then we can draw from a hat and see which platform rules we do for the first round.
Is there any interest in potentially doing a tournament with a mix of Ryzen and Bellator fighters in the future? Has that ever crossed your mind?
そうだね、もちろん僕らとしては今年もライト級のグランプリを秋からスタートしようと思います。そこには本当にベラトルの、まだ言わない、ベラトル の, を代表する選手も出てきてほしいと思うし、僕らはサッカーでいうとこのチャンピオンズリーグにしたいと思ってるんで、これはまあ本当に世界中 の, 大中小関わらずプロモーションを代表する選手たちをピックアップして格闘技界のチャンピオンズリーグみたいなものをやりたい。そこでベラトルの代表する選手にはぜひ出てきてほしいと思ってます。
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the idea for this year is to hold a lightweight Grand Prix this year, starting August. And hopefully, it would be great to have a Bellator representative fighter in that Grand Prix as well. So ultimately, our goal idea is to put on the Champions Leagues of MMA. So we would hope to have many fighters from proudly representing their countries and promotions to participate in the tournament.
One of the fighters who's done a lot of crossover was King Mo, and he just retired from MMA the other day. Do you have any thoughts on his career and kind of what he meant to MMA and his ability to fight between organizations?
King Mo is the most important thing.
でも、キングはもうやらないんですよ、試合ね、だから本当に、彼は本当、日本でこの MMA のキャリアをスタートしたってこともあって、彼自身がやっぱり日本に対して特別な思いがあったっていうのが一つ大きかったと思います。だから、本当にこのキングモーという選手のように、日本で戦うことにも抵抗がなく戦う、特別な思いを持って戦える選手がベラトルにいたってことは、僕らにとってはとても、この2つのプロモーションが交流する上ではね、団体が交流する上ではラッキーだったかなと。
I think the fact that King Mo was a Bellator fighter, which made his professional debut in Japan, and who had a special place in his heart for Japan. A fighter like that being under the Bellator roster definitely helped us with this first getting our starting the first step towards this movement. So, having a fighter like that had a special place in Japan and who was fighting for Bellator, that was definitely a great way to start off this momentum.
Madison Square Garden is universally recognized as one of the biggest and most important sporting venues in the world. How do you and your fighters feel about not only coming to America to showcase your talents, but also to the world's most famous arena?
本当に光栄に思います、ね。だから本当、僕自身もマディソンスクエアガーデンで、自分のところの、ね、代表選手を代表して送り出せる、それがマディソンスクエアガーデンであるということだけでも、他のアリーナよりも何倍も興奮してるし、本当にここで最初にキックオフ、来日の選手がここでスタートする。試合をすることができるということを本当に嬉しく思うし、光栄に思います。
It's a definite honor for us to be able to kick off the Japanese fighters fighting in the United States, starting off at the Madison Square Garden. It's an absolute honor, and for me myself, being able to send our fighters to a U.S. promotion, to Bellator, for that starting off at the Madison Square Garden is something that's very exciting for me as well.
One championship,
last one, yes.
One Championship announced that they are opening up offices in America, possible events in America. He's done events with Pride in America. Any chance we see a Ryzen event in America or an office in America? And a TV deal in America.
まあ将来的に本当にこうやっぱりアメリカが本当にこのスポーツをやっぱりスポーツとしてこのミックスマーシャルアーツというものを育て上げた国の、ナンバーワンなのナンバーツーは日本だと僕は思ってますけど、生まれたのがアメリカで育てたのが日本で、その後またアメリカで大きくしてっていう、だからそのもちろんアメリカという国は僕らのにとってもライジにとっても憧れの国だし、なくてはならないマーケットだと思って、そこにはでも大切、本当にアメリカで僕らが一回だけ思い出作りにやるってことができるけど、そんな意味がないので、しっかり戦略と準備をしてパートナーをしっかり見つけて、もっと力をつけてから本格的にアメリカには上陸したい、僕らの一つの大きな数年先の目標ではあります。
So how I look at MMA is that United States created MMA, we Japan made it bigger, and then the United States finalized it and made it into a complete sport. So with that all being said, we do believe that United States is, America is essential, an essential market for the sport. And obviously, being a promoter, we would like to come into this market is something very important. However, you know, we can't just do a one-off just to say that we did it. If we're going to come in, we have to strategize, and we have to find the right partner and be ready for us to come into the United States market. So, but yeah, that is definitely one of the goals that we have as a promoter.
All right, thank you.